Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to make a cool 3D logo. Let's start it. First, we are going to create a square with 50mm sides. Then choose text and create first letter of your initials. I used Franklin Gothic Heavy font because it looks good, but you can use other fonts too. Height, it should be around 75, depending on which font are you going to use. Then you should explode text in order to get outlines. Select it, right click and choose Fix, Unfix option so you can move the letter. We want this first letter to be mirrored, so just draw the line next to it. Then select the letter and choose mirror. Select line as mirror line and press OK. You can now delete mirror line and unmirrored letter. Select letter and press M to move the letter. Choose point to point as move type and then select bottom right corner of letter. After that, select bottom right corner of the square as second point. Press OK. Letter is now correctly positioned, but it should be as wide as the square. So we are going to select all the lines from the left side. Press M and move selected lines near to the left line of the square. After that, we can extrude the letter by pressing E on the keyboard. Select letter profile and write 50 for distance value. Confirm with OK. Next step, we want to create another letter on the back of our first letter. So we select Create Sketch and choose back of our letter as new work plane. After that, choose text and create second letter of your initials. Other settings are same as before. 75 height and font type Franklin Gothic Heavy. Select text, right click and explode it and after that unfix it. Then select outlines. Press M to move the letter and choose point to point. Select first point on letter and the second on the square. Confirm with OK. Here we also want to stretch the letter to fit square dimensions, so we choose lines which we want to move right. Move those lines next to the right edge of the square. Since we want to use extrude as cut method, we have to choose all profiles except the letter profile. Then we use minus 50mm distance in order to cut in desired direction. Confirm with OK. Now we want to create one more letter on the top of the model. We are going to choose Create Sketch and then select top surface as work plane. Choose text and create the third letter. Font is same as before, but height is going to be 40 this time. Explode text, select it and choose Unfix option. Select it again and move it to the corner of the surface. Then move it 3 mm from the corner in both directions. Exit sketch and press E to extrude letter. Then write minus 5 mm for distance and press OK. Our model is now finished. Now we have to add some materials to it. Right click and then select Appearance. Scroll down to Paint, Metallic, and then select desired color and drag it to the model. This will be our base color. Select and drag up all the other colors you want to use for your logo design. I choose default materials, but you can change it as you wish. After that, select surfaces which you want to change into another color. When you choose them, just drag the material from the appearance editor to the selected surfaces. Repeat the step for other surfaces and be sure to select all surfaces that have to be colored. Now your logo is almost finished. You just have to render it to make it look much more better. Select Render, place your logo to the perfect position and then choose In Canvas Render. This will take some time, depending on how powerful is your hardware. In the rendering line, in the right bottom corner, you can move your slider from excellent to final to get better results. When rendering is over, select Capture Image to save the rendering as image. Write your file name, choose file type, and then check Save to my computer to save the logo. Your logo is now finished, and you can use it. Thanks for watching.